this lesson. The seventh of the 10 items I'm going to address in this specific lesson is about coding, whether you use a computer program or do it manual, with all the different interview data you're going to get. Again, if you were going to interview 20 people and you had 20 interview questions, that's a lot of data to manage. What I suggest people do is a variation or combination of coding. For example, I will refer my students, and even when I do qualitative research, I will do hand coding. I will do hand coding from one interview to the next. I will literally take notes on what has transpired from one interview to the next when something's repetitive. If I hear something in the second, third, and fourth interview that the first person said, or from anywhere in that stream of interviews, I'll make little notes, and I may put a check mark next to it every time I hear something similar. Now, when you get a transcript from one person and you put it into NVivo and then add the others, what NVivo does is basically the same thing. It looks for common words, common phrases, and then it highlights them as perhaps what they call nodes. You might produce them as themes when you do your work. But the idea of coding is, how are you taking all the vast amounts of qualitative information and putting it down into some sort of meaning, distilling the much information to the meaning of what that all meant to not only you and perhaps the people that were involved. So coding is important, and you should understand what different types of coding are. There are different types of manual coding. You can do it hand coding, as I mentioned. There's another way of doing manual coding in the sense that you can use what I refer to as an affinity diagram and look for common like categories and then put information on it, like a title for what those common categories mean. That will produce basically the same concept of themes, but you need to know how to do it if you've never done it before. So if you're going to do qualitative research or guide others to do it, I encourage you to pick up a couple books and learn more about coding and the different types.